if they want to come to action research. So this is the metaphor, and that is what I had explored. I want you to know next. This is my research question. What are the changes in the perception of teacher researcher after they get involved in research? So how your perception changes? Now I have divided my topic, the entire topic into three sessions. First, I'm talking about the background of the teacher researcher. Then I'll be talking about research, design, data analysis. And finally, I'll be talking about the interpretation and the findings that I've done. Next. I'm from Maharashtra, and my students were, my teachers were from Maharashtra, teaching in government school. They were taking grades from 8 to 10. English for them was third language. Marathi was first language. And approximately everyone had 15 years of teaching experience. I had met them in one of the conferences like that, and I was under this project. So I was trying to explore who can be my mentor. So when I spoke to these teachers, I came to know that they were very much and wanted to be a part of this project, because they were hearing in the conferences like this, but they were not knowing. There was that myth, and they told that they faced a lot of challenges in their own classroom since English was a third language. They wanted to examine their own teaching practices. They wanted to develop a network of professional relationship, and they also wanted to know strategies, approaches. And then when I approached them and I said, would you be a part of this? They said yes. So we went on a 11 month long journey of this research work.
Next.
So let's move on to the research design. The aim of my study was to explore from a mentor's perspective the change in the perception of the teachers, the change in their thoughts and beliefs once they undertake the research. So I have taken both the tools. The study was taken both the ways. The data was collected quantitatively and qualitatively. In the quantitative study, I have taken the questionnaire with 18 parameters of perception. But there were some things where while talking with them, when I spoke to them, they said that in the process, in the orientation, they said that this is research. They said it's very time consuming. It's very difficult. When I was talking to them, it's very difficult. We cannot complete our work. They thought research is outside the classroom. And they thought it's academic research. A lot of literature goes into it. And they were not aware of the concept of research. So they were not ready to be a part of it in the beginning. But this perception had to be changed. So I prepared a question of 18 parameters on 5-point scale rating. One being they were not aware of that parameter of perception, and 5 being very, very aware of that area of perception. It was pre and post that I'll be showing you. And qualitative data was collected with while interacting in the workshops, face-to-face meetings, then Zoom meetings, WhatsApp chats, so and reflective journals. So this is the way I documented. Documentation is important. If you are doing a sort of research, if it's me or anyone, if you document it, then you reflect it. That reflection helps you in finding out where we are wrong and where what things have to be done. So that is the way I collected the data. Next. This is my quantitative data, 18 parameters, you cannot see, but these are the 18 parameters. Pre and post, there are 5 mentees. I have 5 mentees, pre pre and post test was taken, the green column that you see is the difference in perception. Then I have taken the mean of all the 5 mentees and the average rise in rating in perception is shown in this view. This is for all the 5 mentees. Individually also I have taken for all the parameters and there is the difference in the perception, in the percentage you see. The same thing, next. I have plotted. I have plotted this. So I have seen this. These are my 5 mentees. These are the 18 parameters that I have used. And it was seen that highest change in perception was seen in the familiarity with the notion of reflective thinkers and the concept of researching skills. Just the idea. So the change in perception was seen in the ideas of reflective thinking practices and the concept of researching skills. And some changes came into being in 3 areas of perception, that is time management abilities, because they were doing it in the classroom. They had this myth, can we do it? And they did it. So I have my mentees who give evidence for that. They had the ability to learn and accept what is going on in the classroom. And handling technology, so those changes, handling technology in the classroom. Then areas like collecting data, this was a very new concept for them. How to collect data, so your documenting the evidences was very important. So that helped them, proficiency in the use of media, and developing self-confidence, then researching skills. There was a change in researching skills, but not to the extent that they had expected, that I was expecting. And ability to explore the research problem in the classroom. So there was a change. Then surprisingly, very less was seen in the ability to analyze individual needs. Still they have exploring that what I really want, and reflective thinking skills. They could not reflect back. They were writing diaries. But reflection is something that comes late on. So that they are still exploring. This is the mean one. Mean change in the perception. That is 62% of perception a change. This is quantitative data. We go to qualitative data. They started finding issues. They usually said that teacher did not think, that teacher was not able to do, so the students are like that. But now they are taking the onus on themselves. They were able to solve problem. Their perception changed, their personality changed, their way to look at the classroom changed. They were ready to take challenges, and they are doing another research in the classroom right now. So they have gained the knowledge of researching, and they have continued the journey of exploring and doing action research. Next, these are some of their quotes. They are able to identify the cause. What is the reason, and at least the cause, and then they are trying to communicate it to the others and talk to the colleagues. I have the evidence with me, and I have shared also the evidences, and they are talking and they are trying to find out the reason. Then they said they are trying to find out effective and ineffective solution. Okay, and they have gained confidence. And there's a lot of change in their teaching. Yes, sir. These are the findings. There's an overall improvement from what I had seen and what they're doing now. Variation is seen in the mentees. You are talking about differentiation theory approach. Yes, there is variation with the students, with the researchers also. Everyone do not take it, though the same environment is given. The them democracy. You take them decision making skills, they do develop. They do develop in the action research. Documentation was important. I had made it mandatory because I myself was learning. My mentor had told me, so I made it. So my book was ready, so their books were also ready. And that only helped them then to write the report. They learned different strategies. Okay, then this is the garden that I've shown you. The next one, this is the garden which is now. This is the change in perception. I cannot see the world. And I have my mentees, you can ask them, do they have that barrier? Yes, sir, do you have the barrier?
No,
the they are doing the, another research. I have two for you, yes?
No barriers, because we got a good mentoring where we cleared out our idea and now nearly our perceptions have changed. Now we are doing it very confidently with the help of this.
Thank you. And this is my conclusion. I take the takeaway tip. Motivation and support throughout is very, very important. You have to motivate them. 80% motivation and developing trust. The trust development is very important. If your mentees develop trust in you, things automatically work out. Parameter of perception should be very clear. What you want and give them decision making power. Let them decide. Yeah, thank you. Okay. Thank you. I'll go.